Hi, welcome to a product review by RoboJax. In this video we are going to have a look at this back converter, down converter voltage regulator that has the input of up to 26 volts and the output will be regulated from 2 to 25 volts. So this can handle up to 9 ampere claimed one. As you can see here, it has very thick heat sinks, two heat sinks here, two filtering capacitor and a large inductor. And this, the voltage can be set by this potentiometer here, and then also you can have a constant current. In this section we have an LED that shows the power, and also when the current reaches to the constant limit also it will change the color to red. This side we have two inputs. These two inputs, the left side is positive, this is for the input and the ground, and this is the output. So two grounds are together, so this is the output and then the positive for the ground. A very nice module for if you want to build your own power supply. This is probably the best one, the best price that you can get from eBay, around $5 or $10, so it's always less than $15. So including the heat sink, the width is 47.5 millimeter and the length is 65.3 millimeter. And the depth is 22.4 millimeter and the module weighs 65.2 gram. So we're going to test this. We're at 3.3 volts, 5 volts, and 9 volts. We will see what is the maximum current. I see at 9 volts, 5, and 3.3 volts. As you can see here now, I've connected the output to this voltmeter. So let's change the voltage and see. The input is now 12 volts, and I want to see the regulation. So remember, this is multi-turn potentiometer, so initially it could be at the position that you need to turn it 10 to 15 turn or maybe more before you could see any change. I'm at the position that as soon as you turn, as I turn it, so I'm doing the counterclockwise rotation, and that is good. So counterclockwise reduces the voltage. Let's put 3.3 volts, see if is it hard or easy. So that's good. Now I'm setting the input voltage. So I'm just going now, it shows 23 volts. So let's change this, because now it's so that I'm turning it to the right clockwise. Again, this is the exact input voltage that we see at the output. Good. So even if you need the input to pass, we will see it. But this is without the load, so let's get started with applying load and check this to see if it can handle 9 ampere. Now I've connected the power supply, and this is the load, electronic load, and this is the output. It shows 12 volts. And also I put my Testos 7701 clamp, current clamp here, attached here. I want to see how much current it draws as at the input. So we will see that, and also we will see the load current as well. So let's set the voltage to 9 volts. I'm going counterclockwise. So now the output is 9 volts and you see blue LED is on. Now there is no load. I'm going to go with a 9 ampere here. So I set this to 9 ampere. And so the input is 12 volts. We want 9 volts. So the current protection kicked in. And this is for setting the current. When I rotate it to the right, it now cracks. So that is at the maximum. So 9, it doesn't support. So we cannot get 9 ampere. So the voltage goes up to 1 volt and it will shut off. So let me change the current to 8.5. Now we are at 8.5. So it seems 8.5 is working, and that's red. So 8.5 did not work, failed. 8. So 8. The voltage is 8.93 volts. And you see the current is 6.5 ampere, the input current. You might be wondering what is going on, how can we get 8 volts? Because the total power is here important. That's 9 times 8, 72 watt, the output. And the input is 12 volts, 12 times 6.5, and you will get that you will not have much difference here, except the efficiency rate that we have. So 12 times 6.5, so that is 78 watt, and this one is 9 times 8, 72. So now the output is 5 volts, input is 12 volts. Again, we'll go with 8 ampere. Now there is big difference between input and output, and it might reflect a little extra load. Let's look at the input current as well. So the voltage dropped very little, which is acceptable, and we have 3.85 ampere. A minus, so failed. 8 ampere at 5 volts, failed. 7.5. So let's set it at 9 amp, failed. So let's go with 8.5, 3.3 volts output, 8.5. The voltage dropped, failed. So let's go for 8 ampere. The voltage has dropped 100 millivolts. It's 3.3, now become 3.2. But let's see the current. So now 2.8 amp at 12 volts. So 12 times 2.8 failed. So let's go 7.5, 3.2 now. The voltage has dropped again 100 millivolts. Not just warm. So let's see. So 12 times 2.61. So I've waited enough for this, and I label this as pass. So for conclusion, that this voltage regulator can handle up to 7.5 amp at 3.3 and 5 volts and at 9 volts at 8 amp. So this is a nice, well-built device. At the bottom, these components are exposed, so make sure to protect them, otherwise they will get damaged. These four pins of this heatsink keeping them a little up, but it needs protection if you're using it in real application. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe so you can get updates of my other upcoming videos and thumb up. And if you have any question or comment, please post to the description comment section below, and I will try to answer and reply. Take care.